So this video, I will talk about the reality of a Pinay or a Filipino living abroad, especially living here in Norway, and the reason behind why I created the group Filipinas Learning Norsk. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. I am Donita, your Pinay teacher in Norway. And if you are new to my channel, I am making vlogs about my ideas, life, and experiences here in Norway. And if you like this video, please do to thumbs up. And if you want to support my channel, please do to subscribe and click the notification bell below for you to have updates when I have new uploads. So this video, I will talk about the reality of a Pinay or a Filipino living abroad, especially living here in Norway, and the reason behind why I created the group Filipinas Learning Norsk. So the main reason why I created that group last 2019, when I started studying a completing course in Norway, is to have a accountability group together with my friends in Norway and some of my sisters and friends in our municipality. But then, because I've been busy, I've stopped posting some of the topics about on how to learn Norwegian. And now that it's a new year, 2021, and I want to continue that advocacy to help one another, I share this group to every Facebook group in Norway to broaden the members and for others to join. And surprisingly, now we have 650 members, so I am very thankful with all of you, and I'm so thankful with some of my co-Filipinos who also share some of their ideas and documents to help one another in passing the Norsk Probe or Norwegian language exam, Theory Probe or driver's license exam, and Samfunnskunnskap. So all of those exams that I've said a while ago is the purpose of that group, to help one another, especially our co-Filipinos or our kababayan here in Norway. And that is the major reason behind that group. And the next reason why it really inspired me to do this kind of group is when I've also experienced that it's pretty hard to face all those challenges and be alone. And I don't know where or who the one that I will talk about or the one that I will ask about those things. So now that I have experience to overcome and to pass all those exams, I really want to share my stories. And that is the reality of living abroad. Because you all know, guys, when you start a life abroad, or for example here in Norway, you will start from scratch. You will start from nothing. So even if I am a Filipina teacher in the Philippines, English teacher in high school, and I passed the license exam, I am a professional teacher there, I need to start my life in Norway from scratch. I cannot use my license here in Norway to teach, because I still need to know some of the knowledge about the school system here in Norway and a lot of things before I start to work as a teacher here. So that is the reality of all those Filipinas, all of those kababayans who migrated abroad. Some of them will start from scratch. It is not like a greener pasture. It's not about they have all the things, they have all the money, they will just take the money out of their ATM account. No, they will start from scratch, and they must learn the language. They must know how to cope up living a life away from their family. So there are a lot of challenges and struggles that we face through, and sometimes we often judge by others that we just migrated or go abroad because of our partners, because we will just defend on them. No, that's not true. Not all of the Filipinos abroad depend only in their husband. When we come here in Norway or in other places abroad, most of the Filipinas that I know, used to find a job, used to find a way to start their living and also to support their family in the Philippines and also to support themselves. They don't only depend on their husband, because when you are here, when you are in Norway, when you are abroad, you want to have your own way to support yourself financially and of course to support your husband. So there are a lot of things that you must also know when a Filipina migrated abroad. And here is the reality of life. We need to start from scratch. We need to learn the language. We must know how to cope up living abroad. And we must face the criticism and judgment from others. It's a tough life, but still, we have our families, we have our friends, and we have our husbands or someone in our lives that are supporting us. So again, this is Donita, your Pinay teacher in Norway. I hope that you learned something about this video, and please do to like, share, and subscribe for more updates. Thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all.